And welcome to another episode of Icons Contemporary Art. Today I'm going to be speaking about a collage made by the icon titled Steve Parrino. So I'm going to be talking in detail, full depth of the collage. So let's take a closer look. So this collage is mainly made up of icons, iconic figures, iconic images, iconic pictures, which are close to me. So first of all, I'd like to start with the note that I've written on this paper. The paper on which the abstract painting, the abstract expression is painted on. The quote says, "I keep having these random flashes about life. Like the cracks of my reality are becoming translucent. I cannot explain it. It's an experience of one man." So this is how my life goes on a daily basis. Sometimes I have these visions of life and reality where the visions are supernatural in a sense, because I feel like when I say the cracks of my reality are becoming translucent, it's because when I have these flashes, I black out in a sense and go into a state of mind which is euphoric in a way, and it's an autopilot. So at that point in time, I zone out, I space out, and I see the people that I'm with, and I see the space around me, the mass, the gravity, the mass of me, my body. I see everything in the third person perspective, if I can put it that way, at that moment where my reality becomes translucent, the cracks of it. So it's a moment that comes often, and I never know when to expect that moment, because my brain kind of like plays tricks on me when the moment comes and I feel like, is this really life? Is this? I start answering these questions, and I don't answer them consciously, but they are answered through the vividness of the phenomenon that occurs when I have these visions. It's not a vision, but realizations when I have these perspectives. So it's ambiguous in its interpretation, but I can quote it again. "I keep having these random flashes about life, like the cracks of my reality are becoming translucent. I cannot explain it. It's an experience of one man," which that man is the icon, and I put the icon symbol, the icon logo of the icon brand there with the quote, because it's a quote by the icon brand. So beside that icon logo, there's a poem by a great poet which many of you know. It says, "Tell me not in mournful numbers, life is but an empty dream, for the soul is dead that slumbers, and things are not what they seem." So this ties in simultaneously and harmoniously with the text written by me, because it's an experience that has a contrasting it has contrasting perspective, the perspective of my text and the perspective of this poem, which is long, an old poem, has contrasting views. So that's why it's beside the icon and beside the quote. So beside that is the iconic symbol of the Christian symbol, the Christian cross. And that also has a damage in it, because the Christian notion is quite, it has a lot of unanswered questions and a lot of doubt and a lot of skepticism around it. So that's why it's missing a piece. And here's the title of the collage, Steven Parrino, which is the inspiration for the whole collage making in the first place. And here is the name of a famous Nigerian actor, comedian, a short guy named Osita Eheme. And it's just talking about icons. And here's an icon of the pie, the symbol of pie, which just for me, it captures infinity, because the number just goes on and on and on, just like the circle, the pi circle. And then here's another icon, Elon Musk. So this individual I think highly of, because he never thinks of himself as an individual. He always thinks of the human race and the advancement of humanity at all times. So moving on, here's another two icons, the former apartheid president and the former first black president, Nelson Mandela. And I put them in this context because I wanted to show the relation of apartheid to the superiority complex and the hierarchy of races. So I put the guy on top of Mandela because that's how he saw it, I could say, when he was the apartheid president. And these are all icons. And I put another step to the hierarchy when I put the icon logo on top of him, which means the icon logo transcends the former president and transcends the Christian symbol and transcends infinity of the pi symbol into an oblivious state of iconicness. So, yeah. These are icons, and Mandela is right on top of me, because these are my parents, my biological parents, and that's me, a young me, in the center. So I put this there because I see myself as Mandela in a way, the Mandela of art. So below that is some pages from a psychology book, a personality theory book. The pages I chose for this collage is the subjectivity and objectivity assumption, sublimation, subordination construct, subsidiation principle of success, motive to avoid, successive approximation, superiority complex, superego, and superstitions and subordinate constructs and all of that. So that just encompasses what goes on into the brain of the icon. So that's why it's underneath me, because these two parents came together to create this icon, which the motive behind the icons is the superiority complex and the subjectivities and the objectivity assumptions. That all just ties in my thought processes into the picture and the collage. They are relative. That's why I put the page numbers as the background on the bottom of me. So beside that is the formula for making glass. I see glass as a huge milestone of the human race to create something so clear, something so pure, something so recyclable. So I see glass as an icon of its own, even though it's something that we often overlook. So I put the formula for making glass, and besides that is Damien Hirst, and on top of the money, obviously, and on top of the Coca-Cola symbol, which are icons, on top of the Diesel jean brand, which is all just icons. So just this whole collage is just about icons and capturing the essence and what they mean, and me as an icon, what I mean to myself and what I will eventually mean to the world, because that's a reality that I am. So it's just I wanted to name this collage Icons, but I can't, because the Stephen Perino is an icon, and his very the word is very in your face. So I decided to name it Stephen Perino, and he's also the inspiration for the whole collage, so why not? Stephen Perino. Titled Stephen Perino. Yeah. So this is today's episode of Icons Contemporary Art, and see you on the next episode. Bye-bye.